Hi, I'm Mark Farber, and this is Accounting Fundamentals. In our last video, we started to talk about adjusting entries, and we talked about prepaid expenses. Remember that a prepaid expense is nothing more than an expense that a company has paid for in advance and then records the expense on a regular basis over the period of a number of months or years or whatever. Initially, the prepaid expense is an asset because the company is owed a certain service or something. And as they accrue that over time, that asset becomes an expense on the income statement. Well, what happens in reverse? What if a company sells something and gets paid in advance for it? In our last example, we used an insurance contract, and we said that a company purchased a one-year insurance contract and paid for it in advance on January 1st. So I thought we'd look at the opposite here. Here we have the insurance company, XYZ Insurance Company, and they sell a one-year insurance policy on January 1st for $2,400 cash. Now remember, they're going to receive $2,400 of cash on January 1st, but we can't record that as revenue because in order to have revenue, two things have to occur. In the case of an insurance policy, you have to substantially complete the delivery of the policy or provide the service, and payment has to be reasonably assured. Well, payment is reasonably assured. They've already been paid on January 1st, but they haven't delivered anything on that date yet, so they don't have revenue. We're not going to do the cash accounting anymore because we don't care about that. Let's jump right into the accrual accounting. First of all, let's just remind ourselves, since it's a 12-month policy and it's a $2,400 policy divided by 12 months, the policy is worth $200 per month. So if we do the journal entries for this transaction, on January 1st, this company is going to debit cash because they received the check, $2,400, and they're going to credit a liability account called Unearned Revenue. It's kind of a strange name, but what it basically tells us is that there's revenue that's coming, $2,400 worth of it, but it hasn't been earned yet, according to the accounting rules. And again, they haven't provided the service yet. So on January 1st, that's what they have. They have cash has increased by $2,400, and this liability account called Unearned Revenue has increased by $2,400. Well, on January 31st, I'll just keep moving this over to give myself some more space. On January 31st, they've now delivered 1 month of this 12-month contract. They've completed 1 month, and therefore they've earned 1 month of revenue. 1 month, again, is equal to $200. So on January 31st, what this company will do is it will debit this unearned revenue account. Again, remember that because unearned revenue is a liability, a credit increases the account, and a debit will decrease the account. So we're going to decrease the amount of insurance that is owed to people or revenue that has not yet been earned. So we'll debit unearned revenue by $200, the amount that 1 month is worth, and we will credit revenue for $200. So at the end of January, the company has now earned $200 of the $2,400 that it received on January 1st. Same thing will happen at the end of February, February 28th. They'll enter a new transaction. Debit unearned revenue $200 and credit revenue $200. And again, at the end of each month, when the company's doing its adjusting entries, it will put in an entry for recognizing $200 worth of revenue that it's now earned. Until the very end of the year, December 31st, they'll do this for the last time. And at that point, this insurance company will have earned the entire $2,400, and it will begin anew next year when they get a check for the next policy from this particular customer. So that's unearned revenue. Kind of the opposite of prepaids, or if you want, you know, the flip side to prepaids, kind of a mirror image of it. We'll go on in the next coming videos, and we'll look at some more of the adjusting entries that a company has to make at the end of each accounting cycle in order to get ready for preparing the financial statements.